Welcome. Now let us discuss about the angular momentum of a system of particles. We have already seen angular momentum. Now we consider angular momentum of a system of particles. Suppose that we have a system of particles. These are the particles having masses m1, m2, m3, etc. Their position vectors are r1, r2. R3, etc. with respect to this point O. So these R1, R2, R3, these are the position vectors. And this is the center of mass of the system. And with respect to center of mass, the position vector of the particle is R1C. So with respect to O, its position vector is R1. And with respect to the center of mass, it is R1C. In the same way, you can have the position vectors with respect to the point O and with respect to the center of mass of the system. The angular momenta of the particles. First particle, J1 equal to R1 cross M1 V1, J2 equal to R2 cross M2 V2. So we get the angular momenta of various particles in the system. Now let's take the total angular momentum of the system. The total angular momentum J is J1 plus J2 plus J3. The sum of the individual angular momenta of various particles constituting the system. It is J1 is M1, R1 cross V1, M2, R2 cross V2, M3, R3 cross V3. And this can be represented as a summation over I, sigma I, mi, ri cross vi. So this is the total angular momentum of a system of particles. Now let's calculate the torque. Torque, we know it is the rate of change of angular momentum. So rate of change of angular momentum, torque, you get by differentiating the angular momentum with respect to time. So when you differentiate this with respect to time, by applying the product rule, mi sigma I ri cross dvi by dt plus dri by dt cross vi. This is equal to mi sigma I ri cross dvi by dt. This term will be zero. This is 0 because dri by dt is vi. Dri by dt is vi. So if you take vi cross vi, it will be equal to 0. So this is 0. So what we have? Mi sigma I ri cross dvi by dt. Dvi by dt into m. This is the force. So torque is equal to sigma I summation over I ri cross fi. Now this Fi, the force acting on the ith particle in the system, or force acting on any particle in the system, has two components. One is the external force, the other is the internal force. The other particles in the system will be exerting internal forces on the particle. And the particle will be exerting an opposite, equal and opposite force, internal force on other particles. So, when you calculate the torque has to be calculated with respect to the external force and with respect to the internal force. Now, in the case of internal force, as I told earlier, these internal forces are equal and opposite. So, the torques also get cancelled each other. The torque due to internal forces cancel each other. So what remains is the external force. So we need not consider internal force. The moment due to internal forces cancel each other. So the torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. That is equal to sigma I ri fi external. So the torque acting on the system, the total torque acting on the system, which is the rate of change of angular momentum, about a point, that is the sum of the torques due to external forces about that point. Sum of the torques due to external forces about that point. Okay, so that is the total torque. Now, in the case of a free system, this external torque is zero. In the case of free system, this external torque is zero. In the case of free system, external forces will be zero. So, external torque will be zero. So, the total torque will be zero. If this torque is zero, the rate of change of angular momentum, that is equal to zero. What that means is the angular momentum is a constant. So the total angular momentum J equal to J1 plus J2 plus J3, that is a constant if no external force or no external torque is acting on the system. So this is the law of conservation of angular momentum. So if no external torque is acting on a system, the total angular momentum of the system remains a constant.